Yo, just before we get into today's episode, guys, I just want to say a special thank you to Ashley Simmons, who does matchday vlogs on Ipswich Fan Zone. He has allowed me to use chants from his videos to put into my Football Manager videos. If you could please go over and search for him on YouTube, Ipswich Fan Zone, and then if you could just go and give him a little watch. If you enjoy what you see, do click the subscribe button, do click the like button. That'd be absolutely fantastic. It helps all of us grow our channels. And if you could also leave a comment on a video that you watched just to say where you found his video, just add in found your video on This Is It FM, so forth. That'd be absolutely amazing. Just so he knows that basically me using his content is basically progressing him further as well. That'd be fantastic, guys. Let's get into today's episode. Come on, you Blues. What is going on, guys? Welcome back for season 5, episode 1. I am so excited to get this season underway. I've got such high hopes this year. I really believe we've got the quality in the squad now to push for the Champions League. So far, it's gone well. We haven't really come up against any stiff opposition just yet. The first game against MK Dons Zala, we won 1-0. We had a completely rotated side with fringe players and young players. We dominated the game. We only scored one goal. They weren't very clinical. We then played Brentford at home and we won 4-1. Brian Burke started today's game with Afonso and Flamme still injured, and Brian Burke turned up and scored a hat-trick. Absolute delight for the young lad. I've been giving him some game time the last few seasons. He hasn't really done well enough to keep that place in the side, but scoring a hat-trick today, I am happy to be playing him against Arsenal today with Flamme and Afonso still out. When they do return, if Burke bags a couple more goals in the Arsenal game and the Bournemouth game, or before Afonso and Flamme get back, it will be difficult to drop him out of the squad. However, Flamme and Afonso are far and away better than Brian Burke. Stuart Serda also scored his first league goal since joining, which meant we won 4-1. And again, it was a comfortable victory. Brentford did get a goal back to equalise and make it 1-1, but they just didn't have enough quality in the side to get anything out of the game. We then played MK Dons Zala in the second leg. Again, with a rotated squad with fringe players and young players, and we won 3-0. We had a slight change of tactic for this game. Paul Pearson scored his first goal as a professional. He obviously was part of the youth intake last season. Pedro Empe scored, and Dimitri Carpentier from our penalty spot scored his first goal. He scored his second professional goal for us since joining in the summer. We then recently played Aberdeen and won 2-0 at home. Again, we used the same tactic. The tactic I've been using for the last two games is the tactic I'm hoping is going to be the one which is going to be able to beat the bigger teams in the season. So far, it's been going well. Dimitri Carpentier from the spot and sole shot and scored the goal. He smashed Aberdeen to bits in this game. Again, just wasn't very clinical. I think he had about 23 shots, only 6 on target. So we need to work on that, but it will come eventually, I'm sure it will. So today we're playing Arsenal. Let's have a quick look at the tactic I'll be using today. So it is essentially still the same tactic I have been using. I have been using prior to this one, maybe some going forward. However, the mentality, I've pulled back to cautious, and as far as defensive shape goes, I've pulled the defensive line back to lower and also the attacking line back to standard. This is just to bring the whole team back to prevent the teams getting in behind us. Hopefully this will help in beating the bigger teams. Man City, of course, are one team we really struggle against. And I mean, being the last season, we did beat the likes of Tottenham, Chelsea and Liverpool in the first 3 Premier League games of the season. But overall, we do struggle against big sides. But I think this slight tactical change could do the trick. Just a little bit of further transfer news to talk about from the season preview. Fernando Fonseca has left the club for 6.75 million, a good bit of business here. We bought him in, I think it's in the second season, free transfer, second season on loan. The third season we made it official with free transfer from FC Porto. He did do very, very well. However, with Timothy Castagne coming in, he then found himself lacking opportunities for game time. We then loaned him out last season. Osasuna didn't want to buy him, but Ingolstadt, Ingolstadt decided to buy him for 6 million, so we've made a hefty profit there. Very, very happy with that. We've also moved on a couple of our players on loan. Ethan Foster, a right back from Utrecht a couple of years ago. He is a good player, looking not too bad to be fair, but he's not going to be getting much game time this year. Hopefully a season away at a club where he's going to play a lot, we'll see him improve a lot as well. I just, Mel Wazzuni, he was part of my plans last season, but didn't feature as much as I would have liked him to. He's not looking too bad, but he still needs a lot more improving to make our team or squad even. So he's been loaned out to Blackburn. Colin McGee been loaned out to Bromley. Harrison Parks, four and a half star potential striker, isn't getting any game time again. So hopefully a season away will improve him. Bailey Clemens has also been loaned out, but he's likely to be sold at some point in the future because he has got no future here. So today in goal, we have Freddie Woodman. Back four, we have new signings Sosa and Mifam, also with Davies and Soundmakers. Defensive field, new signings Suet Serdar. Midfield, we have Palmer, Dizel and Lema. Up front, Qatar and Brian Burke. First highlight of the game, falls to Arsenal, free kick. Lainez puts it in, back post, just over the bar. Aubameyang couldn't put the ball in the back of the net. It stays 0-0. Next highlight, Woodman, the indirect free kick. Deep in our half to Mifam. Mifam brings the ball out to Lema. Lema turns to Dizel. Dizel forward to Brian Burke. Brian Burke, of course, hat-trick in the last game. Can he score today? Long ball forward to Qatar. Qatar doesn't win the header though. Palmer picks up the scraps. Karma runs into some space, puts the ball in the back post. Brian Burke scores. Get in there, son. Fourth goal of the season. Brian Burke, he is really sending a message here. He wants to be starting week in, week out. Flowing Flamini and Fonzo come back, they are, of course, they're going to be coming back in the squad, but Brian Burke is really stating a place for the squad in here now. And Davies, yellow card, free kick, Lozano takes, Woodman gets down, Clow, yes, gets in there, Mifam clears it. So we had a few opportunities against the opposition in the previous games where they only had one or two highlights, but every highlight you felt like they're just about to score. But as a brilliant last minute defensive clearance, which got there, and defensively this season, we do look so much better. Stays 1-0. Half time is here. We are winning 1-0. The slight tactical change seems to be working well. We've only had three shots against their eight, but we have had three shots on target and 52% possession. We've just got to take Ben Davies off the yellow card, and we might also make a few tactical tweaks going into the second half as well. So, made a few tactical tweaks. Ben Davies has been eased off tackles. As far as opposition instructions go, I have been shown all players onto the weaker foot recently, and I think it has like 15 games wins the last season. I started doing this, and it's been working well. I also follow the assistant manager's advice based on pressing and tackling. Tight marking I tend not to do. But we decided to go hard on Bustos, Kolasinac, Lozano and Lainez. Also pressing intensely, Florentino, Luis, advice from the assistant manager. I'm presuming he's probably like the deep line playmaker. He pings a lot of balls forward. So hopefully that should make the difference in the second half and we can keep our lead. First hole of the second half, Dizel with the corner, back post. Ben Davies is there off the post. What? Oh, Arsenal have cleared the Soundmakers though. Picks up the possession, but the highlight is over. It stays 1-0. So 5 minutes remaining, we are just going to make our first changes of the game. Carpentier is going to come off for Javi Guitar, who's played miserably at 6.7. Well, not miserably, but he's not done very well. Lema, 6.5, has not done very well. So Flynn Down is going to come on for Lema, with Serdar pushing up the box-to-box midfielder. Also, Sosa on the yellow card will bring Empezon to replace him. First, or last highlight, sorry, of the half, Serdar wins the back possession. He comes forward inside to Brian Burke. Brian Burke, of course, the scorer of what will be the winning goal so far. Empis, though, whoops, balling from the left. Carpentier's there, cleared. Burke on the edge to Dizel. Dizel turns and shoots, but it's blocked out. Empis now inside the Downs, Flynn Downs. Out wide to Serdar. Serdar again out wide to Soundmakers. Soundmakers comes forward into the box. Can he put a ball in? He can. Carpentier can't make it there. Referee blows his whistle and it has ended 1-0. A nice victory against Arsenal today. I always feel uneasy playing on cautious or defensively, but it seemed to have done the job. We shut Arsenal out. We scored. We were clinical with one of our few shots on target. And we have won this game today, staying 100% in the league. So after that game today, may say two games in, but two games played, two games won. We are sixth place on 6 points. And there are three teams, 100% records on three games, and we're the only team on two games, 100% record. Obviously, we've had the second round, got a third qualifying round of the Europa League drawn, which has meant some of our games have been pushed further back. And this, I think once we've done this round and then the next Europa League qualifying round, we're going to find ourselves maybe with two or three games and how we've got to catch up on, which is probably going to push us into September with games midweek and at the weekend. It's going to be one hell of an effort. But at the moment, I am getting away with playing my second team in the Europa League. They've done well against Aberdeen in the first leg at home. They should be all right for the second leg, meaning we can use our first team in the Premiership, as the Premiership is going to be key this year, is our main priority. But we do want to progress in the Europa League as well. Looking at the fixture list. I think we'll probably come back for the Chelsea game. Chelsea away, we, I think we do normally tend to struggle against Chelsea away. We look here, we drew, oh no, we beat them 3-1 last year away. That's cocked up that little analysis then, isn't it? 2-2 at home, 3-2 at home, drew 1-1 away, and 1-3-1 away. So actually, we're unbeaten against Chelsea since we won promotion to the Premiership. So we'll come back to the Chelsea game. It should be an interesting one. It may change depending on if the fixtures get moved around again, but I reckon it should be back to the Chelsea game. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode, and I hope you're enjoying your saves. Let me know what saves, how you're getting on your saves, what team you're playing with, what sort of tactics you're using. Let me know, guys. I'd love to hear how you're getting on. Thanks a lot. Cheers. See you later.